Hello, I'm Julia Heinen, and I helped Julian Hume and David Martil with their paper on repeated evolution of flightlessness of rail birds on the island of Aldabra. Here I have one of those birds. This is a rail from Madagascar, and it actually flew to Aldabra Island and colonized it a long time ago. And what happened then was that it lost its ability to fly, because flying is quite an energy costly thing to be able to do. And if there are no predators, you don't need it anymore, and birds sometimes become flightless. So what happened then was that Aldabra actually flooded, and all of the animals on Aldabra went extinct at that point. And a long time afterwards, Aldabra emerged from the ocean again when the sea level dropped. And then again, this bird, this rail from Madagascar, flew to Aldabra and colonized it. But what happened then was that it became flightless again, because it still didn't have any predators. So it still didn't need its ability to fly. And that is really remarkable.
Here we have the skeletons of two species of rail. This one here is the white-throated rail of Madagascar, a flying species, and this one here is the Aldabra rail, a flightless one. And in fact, this species here is derived from this one here. The flying one arrived on Aldabra many thousands of years ago and became flightless. And let's just look at the differences in the skeleton that we can see here. Firstly, this is the leg bones of the Aldabra rail. They're smaller and more reduced, but they're actually more robust in certain places, just for example here in the tibia. But the most important differences are here. This is the sternum, this is the breastbone, and this is the one in the flying species. And look at the size difference. And most importantly, this piece of bone here, this is the keel, this is where the flight muscles actually attach. And see how much reduced it is in the Aldabra bird. That's because the wings were no longer needed for flying. And again, look at the humerus. This is the upper arm bone. Look how much reduced it is compared with the flying one.
What this tells us is that for this rail on Aldabra, losing the ability to fly was not a coincidence, because it happened again. The problem is that when a bird loses its ability to fly because of a lack of predators and not needing it, when we as humans then colonize an island and bring rats and cats and other animals that like to eat birds to these islands, those birds are more at risk of extinction, because they're not used to being able to handle predators and flying away. So their risk of extinction becomes larger. The bird on Aldabra is still flightless today, and rats and cats and things are threatening it. So hopefully this one won't go extinct.